Be the Queen, two royals in 1 year. Helena Bonham Carter played the Red Queen in Alice in Wonderland, and now she plays Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, in her new movie, The King's Speech.
My husband is, he's required to speak publicly.
I have received
And there it is, husband King George VI, played by Colin Firth, stammered. So Elizabeth enlists the help of a speech therapist played by Jeffrey Rush. And this morning, Helena Bonham Carter joins us now live from London. Helena, can you hear me? Good to see you. Thanks for being with us.
You're very welcome. Thanks for having me.
We're chatting with you all the way across the pond. Now, I've got to ask you here. The last time we saw you as a queen, you looked a lot different than you do in this movie, talking about Alice in Wonderland. But this one has a lot of Oscar buzz around it. How were you approached to take on the role of Queen Mum?
Well, Tom Hooper, the director, he sent me the script. You know what? I never actually said yes to the part. I read the script. I wanted to play George, you know, the king.
I guess they said no to that.
Playing it, and then, wasn't interested. Then I said, well, Lionel's a good part. And I said, no, Jeffrey Rush. And they said, but we've got Queen Elizabeth. She's the woman, you know. And I said, yeah, but it's just like the ultimate supporting wife, supporting part, and could be pretty wet and bland. So, and also, I was doing Harry Potter during the week. So, I do have two children. So I said, Tom, who does not have children, I said, you could do it on the weekends. I said, but no, I've got children. So anyway, Tom is about the most stubborn person. I call him Thomas the Tank Engine, and he just never takes no for an answer. So I just ended up just saying yes just to shut him up. And that's how I ended up playing the Queen Mother. But I was doing Witch by Week and Queen Mum during at the weekends.
Yeah, they get a little confusing and hopping across all over the place trying to get those movies done. I mean, you obviously juggled it well, but how did you manage to pull that off?
Well, actually, my son did say, he said, Mama, do you have to play the witch or the queen tomorrow? And I just thought, well, that sums up mum's work. I had bad teeth. With better tricks, at least I knew that I had fake teeth, which I kind of miss, actually. But as long as the teeth were in, I knew I was Bellatrix.
Well, let me ask you.
They were worlds apart. And
I was just going to ask you, was it a challenge to play a queen who has living relatives? Have you heard what the royals think of the film and perhaps your portrayal?
Yeah, no, I haven't heard. I doubt if we will hear. I mean, I don't think we even know if the queen is actually watched the queen, you know, the one with Helen Mirren. So I don't know. And I'm sure, you know, I mean, if I saw someone portray my mum and dad, you know, who didn't look remotely like them for a start, I'm sure it would seem a bit of a joke. And I'm sure there's things that we got wrong. But it's been done, like, with a lot of compassion and a lot of respect. And I hope she would approve. But ultimately, it isn't just about them. It's not a documentary, as it were. And it's about a story of human friendship, really, between two men and really how somebody can profoundly help another.
Well, Helena, I want to wish you congratulations on this and hope you get the Oscar. And we're not supposed to talk about the rule here. Fight Club 2. Can we see that? Can you bring that back? I'm going to let you go. Think about that. Have a great Christmas. We'll see you next time after that movie and the Oscars. All right, Helena Bonham Carter, The King's Speech, opening in theaters nationwide.
Sweet.